Hello guys, and welcome to today's tutorial. I'll be making a pumpkin slash melon farm that is perfect for any Skyblock slash faction server that is competitive in farming and selling crops. So this farm will work by manually farming like this. The fortune increases the drops of the melon slices. Now Silic Touch, it will drop the melon blocks. For pumpkin, it doesn't matter which one you use, Silic Touch or Fortune, it will always drop the block. And Fortune does not increase the pumpkin block dropping. Okay guys, now that we know the basics on how to farm and how to use Silic Touch and Fortune on melons and pumpkins, we will look into how water works. A lot of people I've seen using this water line and using one line of crops near it. Now water can reach 4 blocks, like this. It does not reach a 5th block, and it does reach 4 blocks in every single way. So you have the water in the middle, and it reaches all these blocks. All these blocks, you can see it reaches these blocks, all of them. It doesn't even have to be connected like this. Doesn't have to be connected like that. It can just be within the reach, 4 blocks. As you can see, 1, 2, 3, 4. Like this, it can reach all these blocks. Now I will show you how to make the melon and pumpkin farm. Okay guys, we're going to start on the design now. So we're going to use either pumpkin or melon seeds. We're going to use any form of staircase. We're going to use water buckets. And we're going to use a hoe of any kind. Now you can make a water source by placing these blocks. This will always be a water source. Or you can do it by using a 2x2 block like this. Then either one of these will be a source block all the time. Whenever you take water out, of course. Now we're going to start with one block of water. And we're going to place it here. We're going to make out a row of 4 on 2 sides of the water source like this. Then we're going to make this row a second row, and we're going to make rows of 2. Now water only reaches 4 blocks out, so this is 1 block, 2 blocks, 3 blocks, and 4 blocks. It reaches all these blocks, like this, and this is one side of the design. The other side is a little bit different, because it already has 1 farmland, so 1, 2, 3, 4, and this is only a single line. Now we're going to continue the farm on this side first. To continue the farm on this side, we will look at this water block. 1, 2, 3, 4. So we want to make this a double line. 1, 2, 3, 4. And then the 5th block will be a water source. As you can see, we're going to make this a line and this a line. Just like we did on the other side, but in a mirrored place. Now you can make this a double line, like this. We're going to continue on this side, just like we did there. That will be a 1, 2, 3, 4. Again, we have the same design as we had on the other side, just mirrored. Which we will now do on the other side again. Now it's the other way around. As you can see, it's a double line, and it's watered by this block. We can actually leave this line and this line empty, and this will be the source blocks again, the water sourced. Then you leave another 2 gaps. You place this this block will be the water block. It's going to be the outside. So 1, 2, 3, 4, and the second line on the right side. Then these 2 lines are also watered, like this. Now you will notice, this is the most efficient way to do it. But the pattern does change, because of this water source being on the inside or outside. You can make this also water source, and do another 2 lines like that. But the way I do it, is I place this on the inside, this on the outside, you could say. Or inside, outside, you have a double line of 2 blocks here, and you have a single line of 2 blocks here. This is the design I'm going for. But you could technically make this a water block too, and do the same thing all over again. Like this. And then just make this one two water blocks again. And go out another two, like this. I find the way I did it first to be the best and efficient way. So we're going to go for that way, which is like this. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. This should be a water block again. Then we're going like this. 1, 2, 3, 4. This is how we have it right now. And you can make a zoomed out look at this. So now to make this farm bigger, you can just make the same thing all over again. So you have 1, 2, 3, 4. This water reaches these blocks, so this doesn't have to be a water block. 1, 2, 3, 4. And another bucket. 1, 2, 3, 4. You can make another line. Like this. This reaches out 4 blocks. 1, 2, 3, 4. Just like this. And as you can see, we're just doing the same pattern all over again. Just like this. Now you have extended the farm. Very simple. One water source can do this much land. Now we're going to make a second level. And the second level is very easy. You're just going to make it like this. Two blocks in between. 1, 2. And you can make it exactly the same size, using only the size of the farmland. As long as the water is within the farm, it's all getting watered. So you can either make it like this, depending on how you like it. Just the water source falling down, like so. This also doesn't make this have to be a water source, just like so. You leave this empty, and you're just going to make it like this. That's also a possibility. But if you want it to look a little bit nicer, or more organized, you're going to use the spruce stairs, which if you place it like this, you can walk over it, never fall into it, no problem. The water source will still water all the farmland as it does like this one. And then you can just do it on all the places. Now you will always have a place to walk over. You will never be bothered by falling into the water. The items will not fall into the water either. And you will have no annoying falling water either. Now the second floor is exactly the same as it is on the bottom floor. Just like this, we can have a second layer. Doesn't need much. Just like so. As you can see, it works exactly the same. It's going to be watered. Just give it a second. Like so. Now we have a double layered farm. You can just farm the melons and pumpkins like this. Just like so. I will show some grass blocks. Like this. Now you can farm melons and pumpkins. Of course, all you have to do is just place in the seeds. You can either let them grow by themselves, or you can use bone meal to accelerate the growth. That way you will have melons and pumpkins. And that's basically how my farm design works. I will give you a quick view of what it actually looks like at the end. I will just put in some melon and pumpkin seeds. These are a few pumpkins. Here's a few melons. I'm going to use a little cheaty code and put the random tick speed a lot higher. Now you will see how the farm works. It will grow every single block, pumpkin and melon. You can just break the pumpkin and melon. You can farm all you want. Just like so. And this is a very efficient and time-saving, space-saving farm, as you can see. Now, you can use some other blocks here to block off the melon and pumpkin growth on this place. You can use carpet easily. Carpet will block the growth of pumpkins and melons, just like so. And this is basically how you make this farm. There's not much to it, it's very simple, it's very easy to use for competitive servers, but you do have to keep in mind using the locked stairs or slabs is only a 1.13 plus feature. So you cannot use this in any version below 1.13. You can use the farm in any version, but you will either have to let the water go down all the way from the top to the bottom, or you can use some kind of block to go under it. But this will not be able to be waterlogged then, just like I did right now. Now I believe you can just put a carpet on top of the water. So if you're in a lower version of Minecraft and there is no waterlogging staircases or any other block, you can just water carpet, and that will also allow you to walk on top of it, and items will not fall into it. So that saves you some time on that too. Thank you for watching, and see you next time.